Hey guys, perochialjoe bringing you a CSGO video of the pistols in Counter-Strike Global Offensive. So, just want to kind of showcase the pistols here. I'm going to start off with the P2000, which replaces the Counter-Terrorist USP from the different versions. So, there's no silencer as of yet. They haven't really given word on if they're going to add silencers to the P2000 like the USP had, or to the M4 like the M4 had and all the others. But so far, the P2000 is a little bit different for the fact that it is CT side only. That is the counter-terrorist specific pistol. They start with it, they're the ones who can buy it. It's got 13 rounds a clip, which is one more than the USP had. Pretty high rate of fire. You see, its spray actually tends to go up and then kind of lowers down a bit. So, it seems a little less accurate than the USP in the previous versions. Recoil in this version, in Counter-Strike Global Offensive, tends to move upwards rather than outwards, like in some of the others. So, this weapon probably has the best moving accuracy out of all the other pistols. As you can see, it actually didn't raise up at all when you were moving. So that makes this pistol really the sprayer's choice. So it's very good. It has high amount of headshot damage. You can easily kill someone with one shot with a headshot if they don't have head armor. And I've seen 77 damage headshots with head armor. So it's a very powerful pistol. It's got a good amount of ammunition. CT side only. Next up is the T-sided weapon, the Glock. This is what you start out with. CTs can buy it. And it's still got 20 rounds in a clip. It doesn't raise nearly as much as the P2000 did. Still has a little bit of raising though. The burst fire mode, pretty unreliable. I would stay away from it, but if you pull down on it, it's not too bad. The burst fire mode is extremely useful, however, for pistol rounds, trying to get headshots. And I have seen running burst fire headshots when someone's aimed at the waist. So the last bullet can kick up pretty high and give some surprise headshots. It's a lot more powerful than the previous versions of the Glock. Its headshots are worth way more damage than previously, and I believe you can actually get one-shot kills with a headshot on an unarmored target. One thing to note is that when you switch firing modes like that, you hear the click, enemy can hear it too. So that's something to keep in mind. So, moving on. P250. This is the replacement weapon for the P228. It has 13 rounds like the P228 did before. Its firing rate, the firing rate is really about the same as the Glock and USP, or P2000. Still has that muzzle climb. Fairly good moving accuracy. Its headshots are very good. It's got a one-shot kill against unarmored targets in the head, which is very, very useful for pistol rounds. It's, I believe, only $500, which makes it a viable weapon, as you can buy that in a flashbang on T-side. And it's an overall very good gun. You'll see people using it often. Moving on to the 5.7. 5.7 is pretty much useless, to be honest. It has the same stats as the P2000, but with increased accuracy and a higher weight. So, statistically, it should be better. You just move a little bit slower, but that really isn't the case. It's got 20 rounds, but its rounds actually raise up much faster than the P250, and even somewhat faster than the P2000 and the Glock. So, try to find an unused wall here that's not too far away. Okay, here's one. Moving accuracy. Moving accuracy is all over the place, which makes getting headshots with it very difficult. You won't see many people using this. Unlike the previous versions of Counter-Strike, the P, or not P, the 5.7 is available for both CTs and for terrorists to buy. It is still expensive, though. So let's give myself the next one. What is it? Elites? I will fix this little problem here. Okay, so here you can see the different prices: $300 for a Glock, $500 for a P250, $650 for the 5.7. Got the Desert Eagle, the Dualies, Tech Nine. Might as well take a look at the Deagle, but I'm just gonna buy these so that the time doesn't run out on buying the pistols. So let's move on with the Deagle here. Deagle, its stats are pretty much unchanged. 7 rounds in a clip, extremely powerful. Biggest difference is that it is spot on accurate. Spraying it at this range, you get a little variation. Those are pretty much right in the center of the crosshair. Source players, you don't have your random little deagle that you can run and spray anymore. So, it's bad for people who. I would say it's bad for the people who are good with the deagle and source. You can kind of aim. Yeah, you can aim the deagle in 1.6 fairly well, but this is probably the most accurate rendition of the deagle that there has ever been in any Counter-Strike. The price has been hiked up to $800, though, which makes it a bit more expensive for save rounds. So you'll have to be more mindful of that when you're trying to save. As for the power, it's gone unchanged. Deagle is still the heaviest hitter out of all the pistols in Counter-Strike. It will one-shot you, armor or not. So you have to be careful around the Deagle, especially around people who can aim. Next up, the T-specific weapon, the Tech Nine. This is a very fun pistol, I'd say. It is 32 rounds in a clip, making it the highest capacity pistol out of any pistol in Counter-Strike, and even more so than the Dualies. It's $400, so it's very cheap. It's fairly accurate. It's a bit slower firing than some of the other ones. It's fairly weak, but headshots are fairly effective. I'd say that its main perks come from its high capacity, making it ideal for pistol rounds where enemies will tend to be bunched up. So this way you don't have to reload, and if you have good aim, then its accuracy won't generally let you down. And if you buy it on a pistol round, you'll still have $400 to work with, meaning you can still buy a flashbang and even a smoke. So it's very nice addition to the game, I think. Next up, dualies. These used to be T-specific in all the other Counter-Strikes, but they have actually given these to counter-terrorists as well. Same stats as before, 30 rounds in a clip, or I guess two clips. And check the firing rate on these, because it used to be extremely high. Still a very high firing rate. You see that it doesn't. It covers a wide area, but the shots aren't really all too spread out. So, like the Tech 9, these are good for pistol rounds. They're going to be a bit more expensive than the Tech 9, or just sticking with your starter pistol, so you'll have to worry about grenades and manage your money a little bit better. But they are fairly effective. They do kind of have a issue with base accuracy, however. Two shots is fine. They're kind of like the AK. Two-shot bursts, pretty accurate. As soon as you get into that third shot, it starts hiking up a little bit. Anything above that, and it's starting to get into its spray pattern. So, moving accuracy, it's about the same as standing still, just a little more spread out. You can see how the bullets are still concentrated in smaller areas, but you're going to have to worry about hitting your target if you keep spraying them. So, my thoughts on the pistols on CS:GO is that they are fairly good. I think that they need to make the P2000 a little less spray happy as compared to the other pistols. I'd be fine if they made a spray happy pistol that was available to both sides, but as it stands, I think that you have some issues giving an advantage in pistols to one side only. Which, I mean, there are other pistols that are available for both teams that are effective. They made the Glock a little bit better than before. They made the P228, a P250, much more viable for pistol rounds. So you do have your alternatives. The pistols are fairly well priced. I'm actually pretty happy to see the extra $150 increase on the Desert Eagle, which makes it a little less of a throwaway save and a little more of an investment. And I'm very glad to see that they made the Desert Eagle a very accurate weapon. And so I think that eco rounds are still going to be possible. For those of you who don't know, eco rounds are when you have no your team has no money, so you have to save and either buy very light or not at all in order to just try to get a bomb plant or try to get some kills against the enemy. So I think it'll work well for ecos, and I'm really looking forward to seeing pistol rounds. Pistol rounds are actually a lot of fun because they have such diverse pistols. Save for the 5.7 because that thing still blows. But anyway, this has just been a quick pistol video. Any questions or comments, feel free to post in the comments section in here. And I will be sure to post some more videos for the other pistol, for the other weapon types, and some map run-throughs. Thanks a lot for watching, everyone. I'll see you next time.